Something Real with your host, Michelle Bryan on WNOV.
I'm just saying, as I listen to Engine Engine Never Die, I keep on moving down the line. And I think about folks about jumping on the Trump train. it just seemed apropos for the moment because the Trump train is completely off the rails. No matter what it looks like at the RNC, this man's house is raggedy as hell. And everybody, if you paying attention, it's right there.
Raggedy as what?
You heard.
No, it's the way you said it. She said, hey, yo.
I'm just saying. Like, will you? So you brag about, I got it, bro. My paper is long. What my girl say the other day when she was doing 21 questions? You know, I got the means to buy anything I want, basically was the line, was the bar. And here this dude is, you just got done hyping your financial situation. And now, originally you went into actually the court to lower the bond to $100 million instead of $464 million. Now your lawyers is back in court saying, we shouldn't have to pay this amount at all while we're going through the appeal process. And the judge is like, yeah, that you this stay is in order until or in effect until March 25th. And all these appeals and everything y'all trying to do all the way up to the state's highest court, the Court of Appeals for the state of New York. Yeah, even while that's happening, March 25th is when my order expires. So Letitia James could easily be at you, And they're like, this amount of money is ungodly. It wasn't ungodly when your boy was bragging about how much he had. And then, you know, you help people understand your wealth because you're running your mouth. You was the one bragging in a courtroom that, you know, I'm a big baller, shot caller. I got like $500 million in the bank and immediately at my disposal. You told people how much money you said you had. You wasn't being truthful.
Are you gonna call me like you said you would?
You're not being truthful. Cause see, putting up that $91 million on that E. Jean Carroll case done hit a brother's pockets too. And we're gonna wait. We waiting till March 25th. Cause March 26th, it's a fire sale going on.
It's going down in it in.
Let me go to the phone line. Hey caller, what's happening?
Hey Michelle. Just 1 second, you turn my speaker on.
Okay.
You know, I like how you talk on the phone in your English, okay, on the radio. So blow, don't say anything. Somebody don't like you on the radio station, they need to tune to another one. And the only reason why they listen to you on our station because 6:20 a.m. is only a topic you're going to talk about, and you can't talk about anything else. And you're lucky if your voice don't sound black that you get on there. So this is the platform for the Republicans and Mitch and them. They get on here because they have no other station to go to. Okay, they have no other station to go to, so they want to come on this station. But I bet they don't go to a Republican big meeting. I'm talking about the white Republican meetings, not the meeting that you went to. Okay, so yo, keep what you do, and I'm gonna tell you something, Michelle. You're the woman of the year when it comes to Milwaukee for Women's Day. You and Lena, y'all been doing stuff for years helping out the community, okay? So we can pick out people right here locally, Women of the Year, Women of the Month in March. I'm putting Michelle, Lena up, and a bunch of other people up, okay? Y'all just keep doing what y'all doing. I don't have time for all this. Calling on the shit y'all want to criticize somebody. That's why we're not together now. And one thing I was gonna ask you, can you go on the referendum? Yesterday, a gentleman was on there with Kiana, Republican, and there's two other referendums on a ballot for people to vote. And if they could kind of clarify that a little bit, you know, more about that. I was reading it today. You know, if you can do that at all.
Yep. Nope. I'm happy to do that. I'll do it in just a moment.
Well, and it may be just even up until election time periodically so people can understand. And, right. I always heard if you don't know what you're looking at, don't say yes, just say no. And in the school system, I'm going to call the news, they asking for this money, but they didn't say what they did with the stimulus money they got to keep, and then the money they got before that, before COVID, and then you asking for more money, like somebody just said. We need to really look at this better. I'm not one of those people who say, oh, what about the children? I'm going to tell you about the children. I'm going to tell you, I got 100% right on it. I'm going to tell you how you take care of the children. If you can't take care of your children, foster care is out there. My name is Kathy. You can give them to me. Because whether I have kids, don't have kids in the system, I can be better than somebody that do have them in the system. And so can you, because they're not being treated right at home and they're failing in school. Don't just blame all the teachers, okay? And at one point, you're going to have a teacher that's a great teacher, going to be a burnout, and your kid is going to be sitting there because you come up to the school telling them, you got to pass my baby. Then your baby try to go to a regular school or technical school or any kind of school or go to work to learn something. They don't know nothing.
Okay.
They don't know a damn thing.
All right. Thank you, Kathy. I appreciate the call. And I certainly had planned to walk through the referendums. I talked about it for a minute on Keith's show yesterday. George had called in asking a question about them. As soon as I take this call, I will walk through them again real quick. Hey, caller, what's happening?
Hey, good morning, sister. How you feel?
I'm good, bro. How you doing this morning?
Hey, what's up, KJM? How you doing, man?
It's all right, Ari. All right.
Hey, I'm doing all right, my brother. I appreciate it. Hey, Sister Brian, I got a couple things I want to say here. I got, I guess, a comment and a question. I know you had talked about Elon
yes.
Musk.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know, did you see the interview that Don Lemon did with him?
No, I did not.
Okay, see if you can check that out.
Okay.
I think it was just yesterday or last night or something,
right,
did the interview.
Yep.
Okay. And from what Elon said, his statement was, I know you said that Elon could write that check for, you know, that could help Trump. From what he said in the interview last evening, that he's not going to help either Biden or Trump. Okay. So, but you know, that was some words that just came out. So that was just something I wanted to make a comment on that. And I had a question on this, because I think I'm a little confused on this one. Help me out with this one. I think I might have the answer, but I want to hear different viewpoints on this. Okay, so we got this sister named, this is a sister girl, right? Okay, sister girl coming here with her t-shirt on saying woman power, right? Women okay. power, right?
Okay.
Okay, then after her, brother man walk in and say Black Lives Matter, right? Power to the people, like I always like to end my comments, power to the people, correct?
Okay.
Okay, now we got this, Peter to come in and say white power, right? Okay. Now, I just gave you three different shirts that came in, right? What is the difference between those three? Now, if somebody's going to see that white power, especially if Peter came down here on 8th and Atkinson and go in that gas station and say white power, they're going to either consider him a white nationalist or a white supremacist. Now, I play golf. I go everywhere and recognize my people. Now, if I go down to, I'm just going to use this golf course, country club that I go to in Waterford, Wisconsin, Rivermore. I go down there, I have three other brothers, we take our own foursome. So I represent, you know, you might even see a Black Power thing on one of my shirts that I might wear. Now, what is the difference between Billy coming on 8th and Atkinson wearing that white power shirt that he want to believe in with his people? He may not even be a nationalist or a white supremacist. What's the difference between those three shirts that I said? Can you elaborate on that? You understand what I'm trying to? I'm asking for.
I do, and you know, I'll give it my best shot. One okay. of the okay.
I'm gonna hang up because I really want to hear, because I know people are gonna call in and give their opinion on it. You know,
okay.
And I'm not opinionated one way or the other. I'm just trying to understand. You understand what I'm saying?
No, I do. I think I do, and I'm gonna okay. give it my best shot.
Give it your best shot. Power to the people. I'm
all
right,
hang up, okay? my all man. Right. All right. So if I remember the example, the way the brother laid it out. You got a woman that walks into a venue or a spot. She has on a women power t-shirt. You have a brother or sister that walks in, same situation, but they got on a Black Lives Matter t-shirt. And then final example, you got a white guy that walks, you know, comes down on 8th Accent into the hood somewhere. He got on a white power t-shirt. The differences between those shirts, you know, and the implications and the messages that are being sent. I think for me, when I look at it and what the real difference is the fact that one of those shirts actually represents policy. It actually represents the law of the land for most of this country's inception. One of those shirts spoke to the dominance of white people in this country over everybody else. So you don't see Black Lives Matter and go to the founding of this country, go to, you know, chattel slavery, go to Jim Crow laws and the denial of voting rights. That is a loaded phrase when you start talking about white power with real historical implications. Women power, we talked about yesterday, and this being Women History Month, the ability of women to fight for the right to vote, the fact that women, you know, are still paid 71 cents on the dollar to their male counterpart, even when they have the exact same resume, education credentials, in some cases more, that men are still paid more than women. So this fight for the ability for women to be recognized as a equally valuable member of society. Even though it's a long fight, it's still a fight that's in process. Women are still fighting to this day to be paid fairly. The first bill that Barack Obama signed when he became president of the United States, the Lilly Ledbetter Law. And Lilly Ledbetter was a conservative. She was a Republican. But she found out after she had retired from the Firestone Tire Company that her white male counterpart had been paid significantly more than her, even though they were doing the same job and she had more experience and she was, you know, she was longer in the role. But the statute of limitations had run out for her to be able to go back and challenge the company that there was pay discrimination happening based on gender. So women power is still a concept that people are fighting for, but it does not come with that nuance that everyone else is inferior because women are trying to assert their rights and their rightful place in the world. Black Lives Matter. People go very specific. They talk about, you know, the deaths of unarmed Black people at the hands of law enforcement. They talk about systemic, you know, structures that are put in place that are intended to keep, whether Reverend Sharpton and them all say, get your knee off my neck, back to George Floyd. So these are very targeted issues. When Black folks are talking about, you know, Trayvon Martin's life mattered. 12-year-old Tamir Rice's life mattered as he holds a toy gun in a park. And the caller to 911 says there's a young man in the park with a gun. I believe it might be a toy, but somebody ought to check it out. And the police arrive on the scene. And in 1.3 seconds, Tamir Rice is dead. In 1.3 seconds. Tamir Rice was murdered by the police. They didn't see a 12-year-old child who they had told this might be a toy gun. The officer stepped out the car, his door opened, he took aim, he killed Tamir Rice. So Black Lives Matter is not intended to say that nobody else is significant, nobody else is important. But I need people to appreciate that we are being harmed in a way that's inequitable, that's unfair. It's not a historically loaded term in terms of Black folks asserting a fight to be valued. But white power in this country and around the world, you could say white power around the world, and there are implications. So for me, that's the difference, is the historical, institutional practices and systems that come with the ideology or the belief of white power. That's why it strikes fear. That's why it makes people take notice. That's why it causes concern, because I can directly draw a line from that phrase to the maltreatment, mistreatment, unjust treatment of people of color, not just here in America, but around the world because of white supremacist ideologies. That for me is the difference. Let me go to the phone line. Hey, caller, what's happening?
Good morning, Michelle and Kia.
Hey, good morning. How you doing this morning?
I'm just fine. I'm listening to what you're talking about, and I totally agree, and I love you because you fight. You fight for us, and I'm out here, too. I'm not out, you know, on the ground like you are, but when people come to me, because when they do all this stuff that they're doing and everything is blackface, that's evil, I have to speak up for us, and I think a lot of Black people forgot because You know, when they started talking about, they created the crime. Look how they did the city. You know, I mean, there's no money, no money for the city. So you got to let everything rot and you create the crime. And then you said it's black people's fault. But anyways, when you mentioned Tamir, remember they threw his sister down too. She was trying to come to her brother's rescue.
That's right. That's right.
And they threw his sister on the ground.
Right.
And then I was just going to say too real fast that now you were speaking of the immigrants. Now, like I retired from Rockwell. It was Allen Bradley at the time when I started. Now, I remember when that NAFTA came in and they started moving corporations and stuff out of the United States.
Mm-hmm.
And then they had, from what I understood, that they had immigrants working on like the farmland, like that Kathleen Gifford. She even had immigrants, young kids, working on her little land because she was had a little clothing line, you know, established.
I remember.
But what I'm saying, these, it's not us taking the job. These big corporations move the job offshore, and they offshore to make money, and then they turn around and say, they're buying all this stuff in here from China and all of that because we want cheap products. And I'm saying, I don't want that old stuff, the buttons fall off and the zippers fall off and they're on the floor at Boston store. Mm. This is a big thing. And and then they turn around and blame we the people, and the one that gets hurt to me the most is black people because everything is criminal with us. So I'm thinking by them easing up laws for guns, it makes us a target, you know, like a prime target.
Yes,
but
ma'am.
That's kind of what I want to say with the NAFTA and the CAFTA and all of this when they move the jobs out. Blame the corporations. They're the ones that's doing it.
All right. Thank you. I appreciate it. You know, the one thing I will always say, though, when we talk about the corporations, who runs the corporations? You know, these are not just, you know, robots and entities on their own. These are individual people who are making these decisions. I think about when, you know, some of these big banks decided to go in and fraudulently open accounts in the names of people who had accounts at their banks to shore up their numbers. And nobody went to jail for that, really. You know, because the corporation did it. No. These were decisions being made by people. You know, it's funny to hear Donald Trump, you know, rail against China and jobs and like everything you was making, you was sending overseas. Everything you was making. Because everybody looking for that cheap labor. Everything you was making. I looked at like the Make America, the MAGA hats are available in Walmart. Somebody need to flip them hats and see where them hats is made. I gotta take a break. I'll be right back.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee Public Schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
Hi there, I'm Deslyn Smith, the Executive Director of United Garner Homes Incorporated, the proud sponsor of the Nyumbu Opendo Show, broadcasting on WNOV on Wednesdays at 11 a.m. Poverty, illicit behaviors, drug abuse, and addiction have been affecting the quality of life for decades, not only in the Garner Homes neighborhood, but within disenfranchised communities throughout our country. United Garner Homes Incorporated is a neighborhood association-based nonprofit nonprofit organization committed to supporting individuals and families to see beyond their current situation by way of education and mental health, substance misuse, and violence prevention, as well as with the utilization of resource advocacy to empower and promote healing in our community. For more information, contact United Garner Homes Incorporated at 414-554-5538 or via email at info@ughinc.org.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbid.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
The Wisconsin Home Energy Assistance Program end of the season is approaching. Don't miss out on benefits and help with your WE energy bill. Just go to keepwarmmke.org. It's made it easy for you to schedule an appointment. You may also call 414-270-4653. Don't delay. Call us today. Again, that's 414-270-4653. Or visit us online at keepwarmmke.org. This is administered by the State of Wisconsin Home Energy Plus Program.
You're listening to WNOV 860 and W293CX 106.5 Milwaukee.
V 860 and W293CX 106.5 Milwaukee. Now, back to Say Something Real with your host, Michelle Bryant, on 860 WNOV.
All right, folks, welcome back to the show. Michelle Bryant, Say Something Real here at WNOV 860 AM 106.5 FM. Before I go to the phone line, let me just take a second to say, today begins the day. What did Donald Trump say? I am your retribution. Today begins the day when some accountability happens for six police officers down in Rankin County in Mississippi who love to refer to themselves as the Goon Squad. Six white police officers. I talked at length about the case that they were involved in 2023 when they burst into a home occupied by two brothers, two black men, without a warrant, and proceeded to abuse these men in their homes, ultimately culminating with one of the officers putting a gun in the mouth of one of the young black men in the home and shooting him in the mouth. These are all police officers, big white country boys, that just went into this home and started harassing these two black men in the home. They put them in the shower together, nude, and tried to make them have sex with each other. Do you remember this situation? This happened last year down in Rankin County in Mississippi. And the two brothers, Michael Jenkins and Eddie Parker, the two men were handcuffed, subjected to hours of assault in which they were repeatedly beaten, shocked, and, you know, a bunch of racial slurs thrown around. And then, like I said, ultimately, one of the officers put a gun in the mouth of Michael Jenkins and shot the gun, cutting his tongue and breaking his jaw with the bullet. He didn't die. No, he didn't die. In fact, he was in court testifying in terms of what the sentences are, because they've now been found guilty. And now we're waiting because three of the officers actually pled guilty. They pled guilty to a separate incident because they was equal opportunity on some level, because they had assaulted a 28-year-old young white victim. And we never got the full details on what they did to this young white person. So they pled guilty to that. They tried to stand on their innocence when it came to these black men. But they have a record of violent encounters with other people. They left people dead in other situations. The Rankin County Sheriff's Department is facing a $400 million lawsuit for failing to properly train these officers. But see, this is not about training. This has nothing to do with training. If you're willing to put two black men in a shower and try to make them have sex with each other, there's nothing in the police manual training book for that. This is not about training. Unless you're talking about home training. Innate humanity training. This you can't learn that in the police department. Not to take out your sexual fantasies or your visions of torture or whatever that looks like. So right now, these men's sentences should start coming down today. This torture went on over the course of 2 hours. They are looking at five of the officers are facing a maximum of 20 years in prison. The six could get 30 years in prison. But, you know, and while neither of these brothers died, it just don't seem like 20 years is enough. Maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just, it's personal. But it just does not seem like 20 years is enough. Because when you wear the badge and the shield, or the shield, and you work for the police department, it's a different set of behaviors that's expected. You abuse public trust. I got people in jail for far less. For long periods of time. Remember three strikes you out in California, which ultimately people figured out was wrong. But you could go to jail forever, for life.
Forever, ever?
Ever, ever. And a day.
Ever and a day.
So we gotta make sure we mention that we're keeping an eye on that today to see what this looks like. But I can't wait. I can't wait to see how these sentences begin to roll out for these officers. And the fact that you have so few officers that rush to the mic to say this was wrong. Now, let somebody do something to an officer, they're going to break their neck. You know, the flags come out. You know, you got the whole TV coverage. You got the whole nine yards. But when they do something wrong, not a word from the union, not a word from, you know, anybody of any real significance other than a direct supervisor, maybe, or the chief of the department. You know, this was out of order. It's not reflective of who we are. I don't know. So let me back up the question that was posed by one of the callers regarding the referendums. Take a quick second to talk about that. So on the ballot, again, you got a state, two statewide referendums. You got the local referendum. Milwaukee residents are being asked to consider a referendum in which about $252 million by way of a tax increase would go to help Milwaukee Public Schools. This measure is on the ballot. There is a whole campaign called the Vote Yes for MPS bill, or campaign, I should say. And you have folks from, you know, every walk of political life that are getting involved in this. You got Milwaukee area state senators. You have state representatives from Milwaukee who are all saying, yes, we should support this. There's actually a news conference being held today with these legislators to talk about support for this referendum, just as early voting is beginning. So there are people from Milwaukee that support it. I think I saw a flyer that said, like Josh Call supported it, Sarah Godlewski supported it. You know, there's a number of people, Congresswoman Moore, I think if I got the right piece of lit in terms of people supporting it. But basically, the MPS Board of Directors approved a $252 million plan that would give the district, you know, a boost to its budget over the next 4 years. And voters are being asked to decide whether or not they are with it. There has been some misinformation, so let's be clear. If you are the owner of a home valued at $100,000, not $250,000, not substantially more, if you are the owner of a home valued at $100,000, if the referendum passes, that means that your property taxes will increase by $216 at $100,000. So if your home is $150,000, $200,000 and up, that increase is higher than $216. 78% of Milwaukee voters approved an $87 million referendum, approved an $87 million for a four-year referendum a while ago. Okay? So we've even had a caller to the show who mistakenly gave misinformation. If you have a home valued at $100,000 minimum, you can expect to see a property tax increase of about $216 a year over the course of years. You know, that money adds up. MPS has said that their per pupil state funding has not kept up with inflation. Instead, it has led to a $33,000 gap per student over 15 years. And, you know, we know the Scott Walker administration, Republicans gutted K-12 education. They did not fund it at, you know, a rate that was fair. Or, you know, we used to talk about the funding flaw all the time. That was one of Senator Senator Taylor's, you know, she harped on that on a regular basis, the funding flaw in relationship to area public schools and what needed to be done to address that. During a last-ditch effort to try to bolster a fledgling presidential campaign, you know, you see Scott Walker and Republicans decide to pour some resources back into MPS, but they had been cutting them for so long, you know, we're not made whole. One of the things that folks have asked the question about is, so exactly how is this money going to be used? Because if you tell me for teacher raises, you know, are you talking about infrastructure improvements? Like, how does this directly impact the performance of Milwaukee public school children? And you would just think by now that somebody from MPS would have reached out even to my show. I know I've talked board supervisor Aisha Carr, who's, you know, always makes herself available, but to begin to try to explain this to residents, why people, and I know they've been on some other shows for sure, but why is this important? You know, what should we be doing? And there are people that say, well, what do you do with the money you already have? I'm not saying that I believe you have enough, but make sure I know that you're good stewards of the money that we've given you. Then the other question becomes, because you already came a few years ago, you back again. Is this enough, or will I expect to see you in 3 more years? These are questions that's out there. But one of the things that I said yesterday, people have to vote their conscience. Vote what you think is best. But I think it's fair to ask NPS questions about where this money is going. Because if somebody say, well, we can use it for teacher raises. But if I got teachers getting raises who can decide they don't want to work at North Division, or they don't want to work at other troubled and failing schools, then that's problematic for me. Don't spend my money like that. So either way, that's one of the referendums. Let me go to the phone line real quick. I got somebody that's been holding. Hey, caller, what's happening?
Good morning, Michelle.
Hey, good morning.
Michelle.
Yes, sir.
You were talking earlier, and the guy that you were talking with, I guess that you kind of bumping heads with on Saturday from what it sounds like.
Wait, say it again.
You know, the guy that you were, it made it seem like you were bumping heads at some at Meech's thing on Saturday.
Yeah, at the town hall. Yes.
And I guess he must have called in yesterday.
Yeah, Greg Kennedy called in the Keith show yesterday.
Yeah, I was listening. It was irritating me because when you ask a question, don't deflect. Answer the question. So if you can really stand behind your argument or your point, answer the question. Don't deflect off of the question. Answer the question. Because Keith asked him, he said, well, you guys claim to be the party of family values, but the head of the party doesn't believe in family values. Matter of fact, he don't have any values at all. That's the way I look at him. You know what he told Keith? He said, that's unfair.
Well, yeah, I heard.
For you to say that about him.
Right.
And I'm like scratching my head and all the stuff that you just said. Well, if anybody is listening from the Democratic Party, this man owes all this money. Nobody can secure his bond, right?
Well, look, they're not trying to.
We forget so fast. So go back, Republican Party, Democratic Party, run an ad, con, cheat, all this kind of stuff, and then put up where he said, oh, I'm very rich. I'm so rich. I'm very rich. I don't need anybody's money. But he's steady begging. So all this stuff, go talk, attack him about he done had 3 wives, why his wife is pregnant, he's messing around with a stripper, all this kind of stuff. Hit this dude so hard that he can't answer anything because this is what he likes to do. He's a master at using the court system. Whether he wins or he loses, he's going to try and tie you up, tie money up, tie you up. He's going to try and just hold out for so long that you get tired and you forget this dude is something evil about him. I want to ask you a question. When he had that Bible upside down, do you think that was an accident or on purpose?
I honestly think it was an accident, but I mean, it's somebody who clearly don't read the Bible. I mean, I'm just sorry. I don't think that it was a whole lot of thought put into, you know, let me send some subliminal message or let me send some message. I just think you're an idiot and he didn't pay attention to it. And it's clearly not a book you're familiar with. You know, just like you didn't know how to say 2 Corinthians. You know, it's like, come on, man. I don't think that it was done intentionally, but it was just ignorance.
I just think that man is so evil, Michelle. He is so evil. And I'm going to tell him something. He needs to keep his mouth shut. I don't know if you watch, Michelle, for the last month or so, my favorite guy to watch at 10:30 is Jimmy Kimball.
He better leave Jimmy Kimball.
Jimmy Kimball. If y'all didn't see Jimmy Kimball last night, Google it. Jimmy Kimball ate his butt up last night. But it's something morally decorrupt with this guy. And if these people, especially you black men, stop defending this guy. Stop. This party is not a family value. You may be conservative in your thoughts, but he is. Party is not.
All right.
Y'all need to stop it.
Thank you,
Michelle.
All right, now I'm up against the break, y'all. Let me take one. Michelle Bryant, say something real. We'll be right back, y'all.
This is School Board Director Daryl Jackson, who represent District 3 for NPS.
NPS School Board Director Aisha Carr, represent District 4.
Tune in this Friday from 7 to 9 a.m. as we discuss
all things NPS referendum and as we talk about the state of emergency in education in the city of Milwaukee.
This is Martina Golan Graves, President and CEO with Mental Health America of Wisconsin. I want to take a moment to remind you that your mental health matters. This time of year can be stressful, but we have programs and services committed to supporting our community. We are a nonprofit organization dedicated to helping adults and kids live mentally healthier lives. We offer online screenings, outpatient therapy, and a peer-run warm line for support day and night. Call us today, 414-276-3122, or visit mhawisconsin.org to learn more about these services and more.
Do you love Jamaican food? Well, visit Fireside Jamaican Cuisine, new location at 7434 West Capitol Drive. Stop in for your Jamaican fix. Jerk chicken, oxtails, jerk egg rolls, and more. Daily specials will be available along with the original menu items from the previous Villa Avenue location. Business hours are Tuesday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m., and Sundays, 12 p.m. to 8. For more information, please call 414-509-5579. 414-509-5579.
2024 Soul Stirring Gospel Easter Band, March 31st. Sponsored by the new Pitts Mortuary, located at 2031 West on Capitol Drive. Pick your tickets up 45 in advance, 50 at the door. On my way home, the Canton Spiritual. Oh, the gospel poor. He's blessing me. I feel it in my feet right now. Baby, you better meet me there. Brunch at 1, the show begins at 4. Feel the fabulous Lucky Brothers. My soul is a witness. I feel it down on the inside. Be right there at Abundant Faith, located at 7830 West Good Hope Road. All Willie Rogers. We're going to a meeting on that day. I see them marching down the street. Come on in from everywhere, north, west, south. Oh, it's going down. There's a leak in this old building, Bishop Neil Robinson. And my soul has got to move. Don't you miss it. Call the new Pitts Mortuary, 414-447-6000. It's going down at the Soul Stirring Gospel Easter Bash. Oh, I got to stop right there. Brian back in top. My feet got light. I feel myself flying right about now. Come on now. You don't want to miss it. Be right there in the house. It's going down. Come on now. Tipping and tearing. Everybody know he's my friend. Oh, you don't want to miss it. You be right there. That Soul Stirring Gospel Easter Bash. That food is going to be yummy, yummy, yummy. I'll tell you, come on now, Reverend R.L. Bush and the Revived Son. Put the weight on me. Oh, not that kind of weight, because that food going to be so sculpted. Pick your tickets up at the new Pitts Mortuary. Tickets are also available at Nicovani's and Mayfair Mall on the second floor.
Impressions will exceed your expectations. Great impressions, perceptions, everything.
Are you ready to make a lasting impression? Look no further than Great Impressions Graphics and Printing. With over 25 years of excellence in the industry, we specialize in delivering top-notch printing solutions tailored to your corporate needs. Business cards, brochures, banners, annual reports, apparel, and promotional items. Our state-of-the-art technology ensures unmatched quality and precision. Call 414-536-7646 or visit greatimpress.com today to learn more. Trust Great Impressions to exceed your expectations and elevate your brand to new heights.
Impressions, perceptions, everything.
WNOV 860 and W293CX 106.5 Milwaukee.
Now, back to Say Something Real with your host, Michelle Bryan, on
WNOV.
All right, folks, welcome back to the last couple of minutes of the show. Let me just take a second. Caller, here I come. You know, it's just amazing to me what people do and what people think is okay. So there is an award given in Ruth Bader Ginsburg's honor. Ruth Bader Ginsburg, former U.S. Supreme Court Justice who passed away, you know, RBG, as people, you know, affectionately called her. And the award was canceled this year because the foundation, the Dwight Oppenheimer Foundation, who gives the award, they wanted to give the award to Elon Musk, Rupert Murdoch, Martha Stewart, Michael Milken, and Sylvester Stallone. And Ruth Bader Ginsburg's family was like, so y'all done lost y'all whole mind, right? Do y'all know who she was and what she fought for? And you got a bunch of criminals and felons mixed up in this. No disrespect to people with a felony record, but are you serious right now? Are you serious right now? And these are not people with redemptive qualities in some of these cases. Like, seriously, you want to give Elon Musk an award?